TARDIS Sauce. My name is Timothy Harvey with SciFiForMe.com, and I am joined, as always, by the gentleman from Traveling the Vortex, Shaun Collins.
Hello.
And Glenn Bartlett.
Hello.
Thank you, gentlemen, for joining me today. As always, we are sponsored by SuperheroStuff.com, which is a fantastic place to go if you want to get really cool genre things. Lots of great Doctor Who stuff, lots of great Marvel comics, DC comics, all the just go to the website, check out this amazing selection of things they have. They also are able to give us a discount that we can pass on to you. And if you check out, when you check out, type in sci-fi for me 10, and you'll get 10% off your total. So definitely check that out. We're really happy they are a sponsor of the show. Gentlemen, there have been a lot of companions in Doctor Who. There have been 13-ish. It's a little wibbly on number of doctors, but significantly more than 13 companions. You're looking at, you know, 50, 60, 70 people have been companions at one point or another, or
probably close to that.
Yeah. Not all companions are created equal. Sarah Jane Smith holds place in the hearts of Doctor Who fans that very few other companions can hold. A lot of people are big fans of Rose. I understand why. There are many, many beloved companions. Very few of them ever come back. In the Davies years, we got a few companions popping up at the tail end of Tennant's run, which was kind of amazing, and fans went absolutely crazy when Sarah Jane Smith came back to the show. Of course, it was kind of almost a roll call of the 9th and 10th Doctor's companions coming in for for heaven's sakes, the episode just went out of, the name of the episode just went out of my head.
Journey's End. And
thank you.
I'm getting it backwards, but what was the first one of that set called? Something about a planet.
Yeah. So
Stolen Earth.
There we go.
That's it. Stolen Earth.
Wow.
Journey's End. Yeah.
So, those, you know, we got Sarah Jane back. We got, you know, a lot of people have been calling for a lot of the companions of the new series to come back. Let's talk about that today. If you had to bring back a companion from the original series, we've seen, you know, Rose has come back in a couple of different ways. Sarah has come back in several different ways. But there are a lot of other companions in the original series. Who would you bring back? Who do you want to see go up, stand? And I think, let me open that up to, because it is a time travel, you know, concept here. Let's also look at which companion you would want to go against a doctor who's not currently the doctor. So, you know, Jodie, there's a lot of talk about Alex Kingston wanting to work with Jodie next season. Mm-hmm. That would be amazing. But, you know, I've got some ideas of my own. I'm going to throw it out to you guys.
I tell you, to that point, I think it would be okay to see River Song come back as a companion. But on the flip side of that, I think she's sort of run her course. I mean, yeah. Even at the point that they did her, what we presume would be her last episode in Name of the Doctor, when she returns as a ghost of the computer interface that she was left on the library planet in Silence of the Library, we sort of felt like that was kind of maybe the finale for her. And then I think we were quite surprised when she was brought back for Husbands of River Song. In fact, I think the three of us on the podcast talked about, I'm not sure if they really need to bring her back. And then in the clever way that they did, Moffat brought some closure and resolution to her storyline in a way that I think was unexpected. So I think now bringing her back would be maybe a little too much. I think maybe it would push it a little too far and maybe even cheapen what they did in Husbands of River Song. So I know there's a lot of people clamoring for her to come back because she was a popular companion. I think if they did some really clever story writing, that I think it's possible. But I really think that her story's kind of run its course. I personally think a missed opportunity for 50 plus years has been Susan.
Yeah.
Carol Ann Ford is still with us. They have brought her character back in the Big Finish audio series a few times. And I think that it would be, especially now, an amazing dynamic to bring her back with Jodie Whittaker and pair those two up for, a quick adventure. It doesn't have to be anything in-depth. I don't think you need any sort of overarching storyline or cleverness, which I think a lot of people suspected was going to happen in the last year of Peter Capaldi's run. Yeah. But I would love to see her come back. I'd like to know, at least from a television perspective, we've gotten, multiple media accounts of what happened to Susan after the Doctor left her on Earth. But it'd be really cool to get some update on where Susan is, what her life entailed, what it was like. They wouldn't necessarily have to keep it in continuity of the offshoot stuff, but it would be tremendously nice if they did. But they wouldn't have to do it in such a way that you would have to be familiar with the information in the outside media. You could do it in such a way that would give us a nice backstory of the things that have happened to Susan since.
Yeah, I've long been sort of saying that it was a missed opportunity for the 50th anniversary to not have Susan come back. And I really was, as continuity, as much as both Moffat and Capaldi love the original series and love continuity and playing in continuity, I was just, part of me was like, oh, come on, they have to bring her back. They have at least on his deathbed, mm-hmm. he has like a vision of her or something. And I was just waiting for that because, yeah, it's an incredible opportunity to bring it all the way back around to the beginning. Mm-hmm. And especially doing things where you were actually going back and having Bradley do the first Doctor. I mean, there's so much here. And as much as I would love to see her come back and work with Jodie Whittaker, I'm afraid that I almost think we need to give Jodie another year of stuff on her own and maybe playing with this continuity lighter. Let them bring continuity back in. I mean, Susan's like a giant continuity thing.
Sure.
Yeah. Like she's one of the biggest continuity things. This is my granddaughter. Now explain her parentage. I'd love to see that. I absolutely would love to see her.
I think you're right. I think that if they're going to bring anybody back in Jodie Whittaker's, any classic companions back in Jodie Whittaker's era, they do need to give it a run up and let her have some time on her own before getting too continuity heavy. Yeah.
Yeah. 100% agreed. That's probably one of the biggest missed opportunities of the Capaldi era would be not bringing Susan into it, or really any companion. I think Capaldi would have had just an absolute blast with anybody. They would have, hey, let's go get Frasier. Okay. And, he would have loved that. We would have loved that. So, but Susan in particular, I think is probably the number one on my wish list, as it were, for that particular Doctor.
I think the question, it's a balancing act between, of course, being very continuity heavy, which certainly Davies wanted to avoid. Certainly Chibnall's trying to avoid right now to basically give it as, that fresh start, this, that new Doctor, let's bring in and, let's make it accessible to a new audience as well. Capaldi was kind of that window, really. Mm-hmm. I mean, that place where you could, and it's certainly a little bit with Matt Smith, but that doesn't mean we can't bring back, I would love to bring back, Nicholas Courtney being gone, but I would love to see, father and daughter do a unit story.
Mm, yeah.
That would just be, it would of course add to the question of, good God, how old is the Brigadier? I thought you told us he was dead, but whatever. Yeah. That would be an amazing sequence to me.
Well, I think to that point, I think that that was the other large missed opportunity, is they did bring the Brig back in the Doctor Who universe on television by bringing him back to Sarah Jane Adventures. Mm-hmm. He's an enemy of the Bane. It's a reunion for Sarah Jane and the Brig, which is wonderful to see on screen. The Brigadier doesn't miss a beat. He's still the man of action. He gets things to do in the story. But it just had me scratching my head that if you're willing to do that for a show that's an offshoot, that is really primarily geared towards kids, that is bringing Doctor Who fans, adult fans, to it just because of its connection. Why on earth are you not bringing the Brigadier back for Doctor Who proper? And I think in the sense that Susan maybe is a bit continuity heavy, you could make the argument for the Brigadier, but you could also simply bring him back without getting too connected by saying, you know, an old military friend of the Doctor. I mean, it's acceptable enough to new viewers to know, especially since they'd already laid the groundwork of UNIT. Unit return for, I think specifically the heaviest unit presence would have been in the Santarn two-parter in David Tennant's era. I don't think you bring the Brig back running unit still. I think you bring him back retired and you use his expertise. But we'd already established with the new series that unit existed, that the Doctor had some history with unit. And so it would have been simple enough to bring back the Brigadier and say, and back when he was with UNIT the first time, he had some history with the Brigadier. So I think that was a grave missed opportunity. And unfortunately, since Nicholas Courtney passed, we'll never get that.
I would say that I one of the most emotional scenes that Matt Smith got to play a ton of emotional scenes, mm-hmm. but the making the phone call,
yeah,
and hearing that the Brigadier was dead, and the look on his face, and that realization that it was one more piece of the Doctor loses people because mm-hmm. they just get left behind and they die when he's not looking, and they die of old age when he's not looking. Mm-hmm. And that was for fans of the original series, that had a lot more impact, I think, than a lot of the fans of the new series, unless they watched the Sarah Jane.
Yeah, right.
So that was, I remember going, oh God, ow, my heart, ow.
Yeah. It was tough.
And it's one of those things too, as a fan, that you can intellectualize and you can go, well, he's got a time machine, he can always go back and visit him. But the very fact that they acknowledged it in universe on camera was kind of their way of saying, but we're not going to.
Right.
You know, and I think that was the stake. Yeah, it was like, oh, yeah, we're not doing that, are we? Okay.
Well, in some respect, something like that, especially considering how important he was to a significant chunk of the show's history, the idea that it is acknowledged that that character is gone and he cannot be replaced.
Yeah.
And it being part of the continuity and the part of what the character, that character's sense of loss to realize I can't go back mm-hmm. and say, oh, I could, but they're still gone. I know they're gone. Right. So yeah. Okay. Ace.
Easily, yeah. Absolutely. Love to see Ace come back.
And of course, I think she might have expressed interest a couple of dozen times, I think, over the years, that she'd be interested in coming back. She's doing a lot of great audio work with it too. So, and so yeah, if you're, especially, you know, like you mentioned earlier, if you want companions to come back, you can get them on audio. You can get a lot of them on audio. You can get Lala Ward and Tom Baker working together again. Yes. They're not recording in the same room, but you can get them.
And well, if that's possible.
I think they've mended bridges. I think that they still, they at this point now are at least friendly.
Okay. Here's one. Would you bring back Grace Holloway?
In a New York minute. Absolutely.
I think despite the legal issues that they have with bringing Grace back, I think you could. I think that Grace is one of those unusual characters that turns the Doctor down. At the end of the movie, she says, you know, he invites her to travel with her. And she turns him down and says, no, you know, that's just, it's not her thing. And she's got an important role where she's at. It would be neat to come back. I wouldn't want to see her come back and travel. You know, decide, oh, I made a mistake. I don't want her to pull a Tegan. No, I really do want to travel with you. I'm sorry I left the first time. but I think that it would be nice for the Doctor to revisit her, see where she's gone in life. I mean, she was already a very successful Doctor. She had some personal issues, you know, relationships and things like that. But it'd be nice to see how much she's grown as a character, especially with her eyes being open to a world outside of what she was used to. I think that would be really neat.
Well, and also to get sort of the American perspective, because I mean, certainly the Earth of Doctor Who depending on what point in, oh, everyone sort of forgot this, or we all remember this thing. It'd be interesting to see what, you know, how, you know, well, yeah, I was here when the master did that thing, and it was so, you know, that kind of stuff would be really kind of fun and interesting, but again, a little continuity, but it's still, yeah, I'd bring it back.
Back to your point of Ace, I think Ace is a terrific idea because it gives you the leeway of when Russell T. Davis decided to bring Sarah Jane back in the 10th Doctor's era. I think that's the easiest one to do. And I think obviously that's why they went to it. I think Sarah Jane's arguably the most popular companion of all time, both in the UK and both in the US, and especially because the US was first introduced to Doctor Who through Sarah Jane Smith. And I think even if you weren't a fan of Doctor Who, you know who Sarah Jane Smith is through pop culture. I think Ace is that same, maybe not so much as Sarah Jane, but I think Ace is one of those people that American fans are very familiar with. And I think that even to a point through your knowledge of Doctor Who pop culture, classic Doctor Who pop culture, I think people know who Ace is. So it wouldn't be a surprise. And I think it would be an easy way to bring a classic companion in that's, you know, that maybe isn't familiar to somebody that isn't familiar with the classic series, but at least have a knowledge of, the Doctor traveled with this girl at one time. She's also very progressive and straightforward and headstrong and a strong female character, which I think could contrast Jodie's character especially. So I think of all of the Doctors bring her back, any one of them would have been fine. Probably Tennant, again, would have been the ideal one, or even Matt Smith's Doctor would have been the ideal one. But I think that's one of the ones that you could bring back with Jodie Whittaker easily and contrast her with the character.
Yeah. I can see that. Let's see here.
I hate to hog it, but I think Sean was jumped on a really good one. He said, call up Frasier. Frasier Hines would, in a heartbeat, jump back in and say, yeah, absolutely, come back and do an episode. I'd love to see Jamie. I'd love to see Jamie back. What happened to Jamie after the Doctor, or the Time Lords, rather, dropped him off back in Scotland in the 1600s or whatever it was? What happened to Jamie? Where did he go? There's been there was a terrific Cyberman story in the comics that dealt with Jamie as a much older character years later. But I think on television you could do that. Let's plot back down and see what happened to Jamie. What's Jamie been doing? What did his travel with the Doctor influence him? Unfortunately, as we know through continuity, Jamie would have only remembered his first adventure with the Doctor, which would have been the Highlanders. So Jamie wouldn't have remembered traveling in space. Jamie wouldn't remember a lot of things. And I think, even though it would get continuity heavy as well, I think you could explore that. And I think that would be an interesting concept. We just listened to a Big Finish audio that we're reviewing, and I won't go too much into it, but it's a version of Perry who doesn't remember traveling with the Doctor. She remembers her first adventure, but she doesn't remember anything. And so being able to take that character and explore, he would remember the Doctor, but he wouldn't certainly know that the Doctor wouldn't know that much about the Doctor. He would only know what he knew from Highlanders. So I think that would be interesting. And maybe even in the course of that, somehow the Doctor being able to prod those memories back out of him and him be able to be given the gift of recovering the knowledge of those adventures that he had with the Doctor.
I think Jamie too would be an interesting one to put with Jodie, specifically because, not to drag it out and make a thing out of it, but I think Jamie would be a companion that maybe would have an issue with the fact that the Doctor is now a woman. His mindset culturally on things would mm-hmm. not quite be the same as somebody else being able to understand that. And I think that would be an interesting way to look at it and an interesting take on it.
Well, it's also a good time because the show actually is embracing the idea of historicals. Mm-hmm. You know, that as much as it's been a time travel show and they go into the past, this last season has been the kind of thing where we had got very specific periods of time where, you know, critical things were happening, both in terms of, you know, whether it be the tail end really of the witch craze in England, or, you know, dealing with civil rights era. These are areas that the show actually has managed to handle pretty well. Mm-hmm. However you feel about, you know, Cummings' kind of performance, he was half genius in that episode and half, oh, for the love of God, somebody sit him down and give him a biscuit. But it's a lot of his performances are kind of like that, and sometimes it works really well. But no, first of all, I'd love to have Jamie come back, period. I love the character. There's a little bit of little built-in bias there. My family is Scottish, so it's just like, quick to the islands, let's go. Location shooting, do it. So that would be fantastic. I think that would be wonderful. I've been thinking about what would happen if Captain Jack came back. Because on one hand, he'd be like, oh, the Doctor's a woman now, yay! And it would be it. But it'd also be that whole just semi-over-sexualized Jack Harkness attitude versus, you know, the 13th Doctor's like, what are you doing? I think that could be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Not to mention, this is a character that has managed to be across two Doctors. And people have been clamoring for this character to come back. I mean, this is a new series, of course. But, I mean, even so, I've been thinking about it. That would actually just be a lot of fun to watch.
Well, not to mention, I'd be pleased to have Captain Jack that we got for Doctor Who back rather than Captain Jack we got for Torchwood, because I think the dichotomy of the character changed so much for Torchwood that I don't like Captain Jack. Mm-hmm. But I prefer the Captain Jack we got in Doctor Who, where he's much more whimsical. He's much more. So I think maybe what Torchwood does is it put him in charge of an organization, and he had to be the boss. Nobody likes the boss. But when he's not the boss, he's this great, fun guy that I really enjoy the character. And I agree. I would love to see him come back. I think you could toy with the overt sexuality of, but I think that you wouldn't want to do it too heavy-handedly, but it could be fun back and explore that dynamic between him and the Doctor now that the Doctor is a female.
Not only that, playing off this particular group of companions or, you know, her friends, as she says, the idea that, you know, there's such an age range and experience range that Jack would be it'd be like watching a ping pong game or a game of pinball. Everything's just bouncing all over the place.
Right.
It'd be the first 10 minutes of that would probably be just insane.
Yeah.
A lot of fun. A lot of fun, probably.
Yeah, any excuse to bring Jack back.
I think it's one of those characters that you can bring back without very few people are going to be upset if they get the Doctor Who Jack. If they get season 4 of Torchwood Jack.
Yeah.
I do not want that.
No.
Season 3 Torchwood Jack, maybe.
Yeah, that's
part of season 1.
Yeah. There you go. Yeah.
Part of season 1. But no, yeah, definitely the more fun-loving, less Jack does not deal with responsibility well. He becomes
absolutely right.
That's just what it is.
That's what I like about Jack is Jack does not deal with responsibility. And when you give him a reason to be responsible, then it just all falls apart.
You know, I was thinking also, I'd like to see Liz Shaw come back. Now, especially considering Liz Shaw was supposedly written out of the series, basically because they didn't know how to write a character who was about as smart as the Doctor, just human. Mm-hmm. And then she got one of the absolute worst novelization exits. They killed her off in the novels in a book that is widely considered to be one of the worst Doctor Who novels. Life of me, I cannot think of what it is called right now, possibly because I wiped it out of my mind. But it's God, might have been Eternity Weeps or something like that. I don't know. It's just
I just want to say the departure that I remember was, and I can't remember what the name of the novel is, but it was a Silurian story, and she actually leaves UNIT and leaves the Doctor at the. It was a terrific. It's a missing adventure with the third Doctor. Now, well, I know they have revisited that character later. So
Yeah, they've done her in audio, and they basically, as I recall, they basically ignored the novel because she basically dies off camera in the book, and it was just like, okay, we're just all not even gonna,
just don't acknowledge that one.
some of the novels did some really, really brutal things to characters.
Oh, sure.
And some of them we should try very hard to pretend never happened and be happy that some of the books are not in continuity.
Well, and I think sadly too, there's so many that I'd like to see come, back that we just can't do now. We can't bring Barbara back. We can't bring Liz back. We can't bring, as we talked, the Brigadier back. There's so many people that have left us now that unless you recast the character, which I think I would be solely against, it's one thing to recast somebody in audio. It's another thing to recast them in television. Or you did something very clever in order to do it. I think you could bring somebody like the Ronnie back, not necessarily a companion, but because she's a time lady, she can regenerate. You could bring another actress in to play her.
And if they make that character actually scary.
Yes. No, I would agree. I don't want her to be a Missy. I think that's the problem is Missy. I think she had, elements of, deviousness, but I think that unfortunately they made her, they tried to redeem her, which is fine. I like the Missy story the way they did it, but I don't want to repeat that. And so I would like to see her be, if you brought the Ronnie back, she would be bad. She'd be a bad guy. It wouldn't be a companion situation like Missy was, quasi companion situation. It would be as an adversary.
Well, by the way, it was Eternity Weeps. It was set in 2003, and it is not recommended.
Okay.
it's a Seventh Doctor novel, and it's extremely brutal, and it's not. It's a disservice to the character.
Okay.
So,
readers beware.
And it's hard to find because it's a Virgin novel, so that's okay
too. Oh, well, there you go.
All right, this is actually, there's more, actually a lot more companions that have popped into my head as we've been talking, but unfortunately we are running out of time for this episode. Like this, that's how this works, unfortunately.
Well, this is certainly a topic we could revisit from time to time too.
Oh, yeah.
It doesn't necessarily end here because, as you say, there's more and more pop into your head as we go. So
yeah. All right, gentlemen, thank you so much. As always, it has been a pleasure. Sean?
Thank you, sir.
Glenn?
Been a pleasure.
And, of course, thank you to SuperheroStuff.com, which there has just an amazing selection of cool genre things. You need to go check it out. Take advantage of our 10% discount, Sci-Fi for Me 10, at checkout. And, again, thank you guys for joining me today. And thank you, folks, for tuning in. It's always a pleasure. We'll see you next week with more TARDIS Sauce.